cells have inspired a variety of scientists and humans for their possibility to regenerate tissues and to help with wound healing in quite a scarless fashion. Even though in preclinical data they have generated good results, the transfer to the clinic in different diseases, in particular in non-healing wounds, is still lacking. And this is mainly due to the fact that, for example, mesenchymal stem cells, they cannot be quite reliably isolated. More recently, a single cell surface molecule, the ABCD5 transporter, has been identified in a newly characterized mesenchymal stem cell or mesenchymal stromal cell. And we had the chance to help with this characterization. And I think this may be at least a preclinical breakthrough and is on its way to the clinic in a phase 2 study with good, very convincing results, even though in little numbers of patients. So what have we found? More recently, we found that stem cells are like adaptive drug stores. So they can sense their microenvironment of different wound conditions, and they can exactly shape an answer with the release of different molecules which help the wound to heal. Why is that important? Because it is very important the wound undergoes different phases. And if you inject just a growth factor, which has been done previously, you can never sense, is that enough, is that not enough, or what comes next. The mesenchymal stem cells can do this. So we had been interested for quite a while in non-healing wound, chronic venous leg ulcers, and these ulcers, they are due to a valve insufficiency, and a lot of pressure is in the veins of the lower limb. And this results in the fact that red blood cells are pressed through the veins into the tissue, and this drives a terrible inflammation. There is an unrestrained activation of M1 macrophages, and these that we found drive the whole process. The wound cannot progress through the different phases and stages of wound healing, and the wound does not heal. That is bad, and there is no real cure. Certainly you can operate, and you should operate the venous valve insufficiency, but there is currently not a good cure. And therefore, we set out how we can use or employ mesenchymal stem cells to bring down the unrestrained activation of M1 macrophages. And the beauty we had a couple of years ago is that there was a researcher who found ABCB5 to be selectively expressed on mesenchymal stem cells under certain conditions. And with this, you can purify under GMP condition. This has been done by Tiseba and Riacel. Those mesenchymal stem cells from the skin expanded. What we did is we characterized these cells. They are really stem cells. Even if you have them in culture after a couple of weeks, they still express mesenchymal as well as stem cell markers. They have the potential of tree lineage differentiation, so they can undergo adipogenic, osteogenic, dermogenic and also chondrogenic differentiation, and they have self-renewal capacities. That is a characteristic of stem cells. And with these cells, we have done experiments in a model previously developed by us. It's a model in mice, where mice are overloaded with iron. This is a characteristic of chronic venous leg ulcers in humans. They all have this brownish skin. As a matter of iron accumulation. So we set up this mouse model. This mouse model completely reframed what we have observed in human chronic venous leg ulcers with an unrestrained activation of M1 cells. And when injecting those viable human cells, so it's a xenotransplant, the mice healed much better, significantly better. And when studying the different wound phases, we could show that first M1 macrophages undergo a switch to M2 macrophages, the release of effector molecules like tumor necrosis factor alpha, interleukin 12 is reduced, and M2 macrophages, regenerative cytokines of regenerative M2 macrophages are released much more. You have an enhanced re-epithelialization over the wounds, iron overload wounds. You have a contraction of the wounds, and it heals much better. That was exciting. And in particular, as we could show that these cells, human cells, did not survive longer than 3 days in a mouse. That is what we want. We don't want an engraftment. But we wanted the sensing of this hostile microenvironment of chronic wounds, and we really wished to exploit this. And finally, we identified the molecule which is released from injected mesenchymal stem cells, ABCB5 positive mesenchymal stem cells. It is interleukin-1 receptor antagonist, and that makes a whole lot of sense, because in chronic venous leg ulcers and in iron overload marine wounds, you have a lot of IL-1 alpha and beta and TNF alpha. And if you can disrupt these pro-inflammatory cytokines, then the whole vicious cycle of self-perpetuation is interrupted. And the amazing thing is that the M2 macrophages came up. So what we have here, we have a cell which do not engraft and which obviously by the release of paracrine factors can fully redirect a non-healing wound to a healing situation. And this company has done biodistribution and safety studies, and they are published now in Cytotherapy. And a multi-center study, phase 2 study, has been set up for chronic venous leg ulcers. And certainly another person is coordinating it, because I'm more in the preclinic, but our clinic is also recently contributing. And they have shown and also released the first 20 patients. I have seen them. And there is no one which completely failed. They have different healing rates, that is clear. We are all individuals, but there is no one who distinctly fails. And you have to consider that is a fraction of chronic venous leg ulcers which do not heal. Even if you have compression stockings or did everything, the tissue is so much switched to a hostile microenvironment, they do not heal. So even though as a scientist, we have to wait for the full data set and possibly for a repetitive study with high numbers, but I'm quite excited, and I'm convinced that good science really drives good products.